Over the past weeks, I've tested ChatGPT Plus and Gemini Advanced, and probably my opinion will be a huge surprise to all GPT fans, because after using both subscriptions, my preference is with Gemini Advanced. Before you call me crazy, watch the reasons behind this preference. So here are the 5 reasons why I think Gemini Advanced is smashing ChatGPT Plus. Number 1. The first is Gemini's larger context window makes it smarter. In other words, more is better. One significant difference between Gemini Advanced and ChatGPT Plus is the size of their context windows. Gemini 1.5 Pro has a 2 million token context window, broadly eclipsing the 128,000 token window offered by ChatGPT Plus. Gemini Advanced can process and remember around 3,000 pages of text in a single conversation, whereas ChatGPT Plus might max out under 200 pages. However, the size of its context window depends on which Gemini model you use. For example, version 2.0 Flash has a 1 million token context window, which is impressive, half capacity of the 1.5 Pro version, but still 8 times more than GPT Plus. This difference in context windows has implications for various applications. For one thing, Gemini can analyze extensive datasets, identifying themes that would be lost with a smaller context window. For example, book authors can collaborate with Gemini on long-form content, receiving feedback and suggestions that consider the entire narrative. Even in everyday use, a larger context window means Gemini can maintain a more coherent and informed conversation, provided it's within the same chat. Number 2. The second reason is the native workspace integrations improve workflows. In this case, Gemini Advanced ties it all together. We already know that Google's Gemini Advanced and OpenAI's ChatGPT Plus are increasingly integrating AI into essential workspaces, but they take different approaches. Google offers deep integration with its workspace solutions, such as Calendar, Gmail, Docs, Slides, and Sheets, while OpenAI is paired with Microsoft and developing its system accordingly. So if you use Microsoft 365, you might prefer what ChatGPT Plus offers. I usually work with 365 and Workspace, and find that the two are not on a level playing field in terms of integrations. Workspace takes a more holistic approach to spreading Gemini's brain across its ecosystem, whereas Microsoft's integrations feel like an add-on. For example, while I can ask Copilot, powered by ChatGPT, to summarize a document in Word, it can't automatically pull context from an Outlook email or a PowerPoint presentation to tailor that summary. In contrast, Gemini can do that within Workspace. This difference highlights how Gemini is more deeply woven into Google's suite, allowing better user experience. Number 3. The third reason, and a big one for me, is that you can create gems. This is a new functionality of Gemini, which allows you to have an expert in a specific field, so you can learn a specific topic, review your code, or have a brainstormer help you with your goals or creativity. It has pre-built gems for these queries, but if you need something more specific, like a German tutor or a desk researcher, you can build your own AI expert to help you. You can now upload up to 10 files when creating a gem, giving them additional context to provide more tailored and helpful responses. In my case, learning German's a big deal, so I found a good way to have a tutor available 24/7 to solve any doubt or get me to practice in the middle of the night by uploading 5 ebooks. These are a few examples, but I think it will be a game changer in the future, since you don't have to give specific initial prompts to start making questions like you would with GPT. Therefore, a gem helps to accomplish more goals and get tasks done faster, which is worth the money. Before we continue, let me know if you're enjoying the video. Hit the like button and feel free to give your feedback in the comments. Let's continue now. Number 4. The next reason came out because when you purchase a regular subscription of something, and suddenly you receive more upgrades in your day-to-day utilities, for sure it will bring a better impression and the sensation of taking a good decision with your money. And this totally applies to Gemini Advance, where the bundled upgrades and discounts are making the difference. And one great thing about subscribing to Gemini Advanced is the larger amount of cloud storage bundled with it as part of Google One. While free Google accounts offer a standard 15 gigs shared across Drive, Gmail, and Photos, Gemini Advanced includes a relatively massive 2 TB storage. This lets you store more data, including large media files, without running out of space. This can be a benefit, especially if you've used Drive for a while and are nearing its free storage limits. A subscription to Google One also affords a few other notable perks. For starters, you can create a family group with up to 6 members, including yourself. If one of your family members runs out of the standard 15 gigs of free drive storage, they can pull from your larger 2 TB allotment. The program also includes a 10% discount on Google hardware, such as Nest devices ranging from video doorbells and thermostats to smart speakers. If you buy enough Google devices, the savings could add up. And number 5, the last reason, and very important for me, is that with the subscription, you have access to future updates and perks. One huge change will be the inclusion of Notebook LM Plus as part of the membership in the first quarter of 2025. This will allow you to do more with your personal datasets. If you're curious of Notebook LM capabilities, take a look to the video popping up on the screen and come back after you watch the entire presentation of this amazing tool. Now, going back to the point, let me tell you I'm a big fan of Notebook LM for its capabilities as a smart data warehouse. And with Notebook LM Plus, my use cases will not be constrained anytime soon. I love Notebook LM because it can take a ton of dry information that I feed to it and distill it into salient takeaways and engaging virtual podcasts. Compared to the free version of Notebook LM, the premium version puts fewer limitations on my data aggregation, research, and output capabilities. This gives Gemini Advanced an edge over ChatGPT Plus for my needs and probably for students, researchers, and podcasters. So by having this subscription, you'll have access to many upgrades, which includes increased capacity for notebooks from 100 to more than 500, and source materials from 50 to more than 300. This means you can manage larger, longer-term projects in Notebook LM Plus. Moreover, you could output more than 20 virtual podcasts per day instead of 3 in the free version. Notebook LM Plus also offers customization options, such as adjusting the AI's response style to suit your needs. Notebook LM Plus introduces deeper collaborative capabilities, including view-only sharing and usage analytics, such as daily active users and weekly usage trends. These upgrades bring a lot of possibilities to many users. Can you imagine some of these possibilities? Let's wrap up a bit and give recognition to GPT, because we all know Gemini Advanced can't compete with ChatGPT Plus in a few areas. For example, Google's Imagen image generation was yanked from the platform due to biases and inaccuracies and remained conspicuously absent for many months. It recently returned to the platform with Imagen 3, which in my experience, the current iteration of Imagen feels watered down, lacks creativity, and is uninspiring. It's so weak that I don't enjoy using it. Let's hope this changes in the future. But at the moment, OpenAI is killing it with DALL-E, and its ability to create compelling images from text prompts is impressive, especially compared to Imagen 3. Meanwhile, Sora's ability to generate high-quality videos from text descriptions is making waves among DIY filmmakers. Despite their groundbreaking capabilities, DALL-E and Sora don't influence my preference for Gemini Advanced. My primary use cases involve research, learn and analysis, where Gemini Advanced excels, and while I appreciate what OpenAI achieved in terms of visual AI, it's not enough to sway me. The choice between Gemini Advanced and ChatGPT Plus depends on personal preferences, whether you're more attached to the Google or Microsoft stacks, and specific needs in terms of visual content or research. Both models harness timely information. To test this, I asked each of them to tell me about the recent snowstorms in the western part of the US. For this task, Gemini Advanced and ChatGPT Plus answered accurately and in detail, rather than GPT. In my case, I'm not a developer, but both models score similarly in their coding capabilities. GPT-01 kills a bit, but if you're a coder, maybe you should be considering Anthropic solutions, which are way better. So to close the video, Gemini Advanced's combination of a massive context window, the creation of gems, future access to Notebook LM Plus, bundled storage, and seamless integration with the Google ecosystem make it my preference. While I acknowledge the strengths of ChatGPT Plus, particularly its availability to third-party developers and impressive visual AI tools, they don't outweigh the advantages Gemini Advanced offers for my needs. Let me know in the comments which one you prefer. And if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, drop a comment, and subscribe for more AI content. See you in the next video!